Well, joining us now is GB News' very own Inaya Folarin Iman, who's been looking into this report. Inaya, so what does it say?
Well, essentially it says that 20 years after the McPherson report in the late 90s, that actually many of the areas of social life and within the police as an institution hasn't made the kinds of progress that it originally wanted in relation to recruitment and retention, stop and search rates, but also confidence in the police by certain ethnic minority communities. So it has a range of things. I mean, I personally have a healthy scepticism of the report. I think that actually I'm agreeing with Cressida Dick on this occasion. Actually, after the McPherson report, the police went through a huge transformation in terms of recruitment, retention in relation to reporting of hate crimes and racist incidents and things like that. And it did make quite a significant transformation. And I worry that this kind of periodic, every few years, framing the police as institutionally racist can actually, to some extent, be part of the problem when they're coming to struggling to recruit diverse people. Because actually, when you're framing the institution as hostile to people from ethnic minority communities, not confident and related to those communities. And is it really surprising that increasingly certain groups don't really feel like they want to join the police? So I think that I worry about this kind of narrative of the police as institutionally racist, fundamentally unchanging, when actually we know that over the last 20 years, the police has gone through quite a significant transformation.
Now, there were 70 points in that McPherson report, and one of them, and you sort of alluded to it, was that the police should mirror the ethnic mix of the communities that they serve. Is that a realistic expectation, or are we really setting us up for failure? And actually, is that the right approach? We've already had people messaging in saying, actually, you'd get the best person for the job.
Well, I think I can understand both sides. Obviously, if police is meant to be community policing, relating to those communities, then you can understand why, as an instrument of the state, as an example of the state and where they can actually use violence, you might want to feel that your police reflects you in some way or has your best interests at heart. And I don't think that those things are necessarily synonymous with it actually looking like the community as such. But I think I can understand why you want to see the police being diverse, as it is a body of the state, essentially. But I also think that actually most people, when they call up the police, they're not looking for, you know, have they got the same skin colour as me? They're looking at, are they going to be respectful? Are they going to be doing a good job? Are they well trained? And I think that that's the priorities of what any police force should be thinking, not necessarily has it got the exact same proportion skin colour of a particular area.
In saying that, when you look at the current figures, I think 7% of officers in England and Wales are from ethnic minority backgrounds compared to 14% of the general population, and there are big disparities in different parts of the country. And I get that, obviously, you want a police officer to fundamentally be very good at the job, but at the same time, we police in this country by consent, don't we? And we have a community-based police system. Most of our officers aren't armed. Most of our officers, in theory, should be in their communities. And frankly, it is a lot more difficult, let's say, for a white police officer to somehow understand the nuances and the grievances and the particular kind of potential difficulties that communities are dealing with if you know, they are looking at a black community in Brixton or a Southeast Asian community in parts of Birmingham. That does become tricky, doesn't it?
Well, we do know that there is a higher proportion of ethnic minority people in those areas of the police. But actually, when it said that BME community confidence in police is still underrepresented, actually, we have to question this idea of BAME because it's homogenising an entire group of ethnic minority people. And actually, when we look at the data more specifically, actually, black African people have a higher on average confidence in British police. So do Indian communities have a higher on average, and some other ethnic minorities have a lower on average. So actually just homogenising and saying BME people have a lack of confidence in the police in order to push forward a narrative that the police don't relate to those communities, I just think it doesn't stack up to the accuracy of what the information actually says.
Can I ask about stop and search? Because obviously that's another issue that we've been focusing on, actually, irrespective of this report, because the government came out this week, didn't they, and they said that they are going to expand stop and search after years in which it's kind of been stepped back from. I was saying in the last hour, I've never been, you know, I've lived in London, I've never been stopped and searched by the police ever. Nana, you were saying you have.
I have actually been stopped by the police, yes.
Where do we feel about stop and search?
So I think it's mixed. I think, for example, let's say you're going into an airport, everybody is searched, but the amount of people realistically that are going to have contraband is a tiny amount of people. But people think, OK, the risk is so high enough if people did have contraband that everybody ends up being stopped and searched. So it's actually obviously something very blanket, it's very broad, and it's often can increase hostile relationships, for example, if you do have a negative relationship or a negative incident with the person doing it. But we understand in certain instances that that is OK. And similar with stop and search, we know that black males are 24 times more likely to be a victim of murder than other ethnic groups. This is obscene numbers. I mean, we're talking about young boys in particular, particularly the age between 18 and 24. And so what are the police meant to do about that? If they have particular intelligence about how somebody, what somebody looks like in a particular community that has higher on average levels of violent crime, then I think to some extent they're damned if they do, damned if they don't. Absolutely, we should review if there's better ways we can do it that are much more targeted with better intelligence. But I think to completely remove or to reduce something that has actually removed knives off of the streets in communities that do experience higher levels of crime, I think it is just not necessarily the answer.
Well, and also if you speak to some of the parents of those victims of knife crime, they would say, keep up, stop and search. So I don't know who they're talking to about this, but I think it almost seems to be this sort of this image that the police are trying to portray.
Well, one thing very quickly, the thing that I will say that any of these social issues are not going to be solved solely by the police. There's other things that need to be involved. Education, economic investment, public health approaches. Absolutely, we should take a multi-pronged approach. But to just demonise the police, who are actually putting their lives often in danger every single day to keep our streets safe, I don't think is the right approach.
Welcome to the GB News YouTube channel. You can watch us live 24 hours a day, catch up on your favourite shows and join in the conversation in the comments below.
Don't forget to subscribe and you'll never miss any of our exclusive content.